Hey guys and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And this video we are going to talk about oral radiology. So without further ado, let's get started. So welcome back to another lecture. And this video we are going to talk about the X-ray film. What are the components of X-ray film? You all have seen the IOPR films, right? Nowadays this is a digital world. I know that most of the students are learning directly from the RVG. So because of the digital technology, so people are not using much the radiographic film. Unlike our time was the old time, we used to take from IOPRs itself. So what is there in an IOPR? That you should be aware of, that you should know. Because then only we will know that how there is a processing. So we'll understand all these things. And now why we want to understand all these things? Because we want to know what are the defects which are caused. Okay, fine. Coming back to X-ray film. So what is there? In between, a base is there. You all have seen that IOPR films, right? You all have seen OPGs if you are reading this in the oral radiology department. Now if you look at the film, it is very thin film and there has got a bluish tinge in the film, right? Little bluish film is there. So what happens in between the inner layer we have got is the base layer. Above we have is the emulsion layer. Now, emulsion layer is thinner. Why do we require emulsion layer? Because we want that X-ray to bind. We want something which is sensitive to the X-rays. Which is this emulsion is sensitive to the X-rays as well as it is sensitive to the visible rays also. So we have got emulsion on both the sides. And on the top of that, because we do not want that emulsion to be damaged, so the topmost layer we have got is the supercoat. So there is a coating to prevent damage, mechanical damage of the emulsion. We do not want that if there is any scratch or if there is any scratch or anything. We do not want that. If you have seen, after you do the processing, you see that if you try to scratch the X-ray film, it will get scratched. But we do not want that emulsion to get damaged. That is why superior coat or the super coat we are doing. So we are overcoating it or we are doing a superior coat or a super coat, right? So what is the component of this whole thing? We call it X-ray. So X-ray, I know that you have seen this very thin sheets. But this thin sheet also is composed of all these things. Right? So these in between we have got a base. And up above that is an emulsion layer. So base and emulsion is joined with the adhesive. Otherwise they'll get separated, right? So the two main component we have got, X-ray film, we have got the base and we have got the emulsion, right? So the base is made up of, now base has got a very long history if you look at, because what happened, Röntgen, you remember Röntgen discovered X-ray, right? And he was awarded with a Nobel Prize also. In fact, he was the first physician in 1895, I guess. He discovered X-rays and 1901. That was he discovered on November. So, November 1895 and 1901, he got awarded with a Nobel Prize. And in fact, he was the first physician to awarded with a Nobel Prize. So, what he used while taking a radiograph, while taking an X-ray, the material which he used was a glass material. So initially he took, no, let me show you before reading ahead, let me show you. So suppose this is the X-ray film. So on the top layer, we have got a super coat and if we separate both the sides, we have got emulsion. So this is not completely coated, but it is going to be completely coated. And once you see in between two emulsions, we have got a base, right? So this is how it is going to be, a base layer, then the two sides emulsion layer, which is joined with the adhesive, and upper layer we have got the super coat. So this is how X-ray film is made up of. These are the components of an X-ray film. So you know what happens. So Rontgen used glass as a base metal. So initially he used this glass metal, and but there was again there was a high exposure and the glass broke easily. So later on, at the time of World War First, what happens? There was a shortage of the glass. So in 1920, the cellulose nitrate was the material to be used as a base for IOPR film. But what happened? The film would wrap with the age. So from 1960s, we are using the same material, which is our polyester. So since that time, 1960s, we are using polyester as the base material because it is flexible. Have you seen the X-ray film? Suppose if I want to take X-ray of maxillary posterior region, then I do not want that the film is rigid, because I want to little bit bend the film, right? I want to bend it and I want to adapt it little bit according to the palate. So this is the reason that we wanted base which is little bit flexible, which is also durable and dimension is stable. So we used polyester, and we are using polyester since 1960. So since that time we are using polyethylene terephthalate. You can write it down if you want, or in the end you can take a screenshot. Polyethylene tetraphthalate. So this is the base material which we used. Now coming to the emulsion. Now what is the use of the emulsion? Now we know that base, we want something which is durable. Emulsion, if we talk about, emulsion is something which is sensitive towards the radiation, which is going to catch the radiation. So we want such a base that is going to catch the radiation, that is sensitive for X-rays. So that records the image. So this emulsion is made up of latent image formation. We are going to study in the coming video. So this emulsion is made up of silver halide. Now this silver halide is made up of silver bromide plus silver iodide, and the combination of both of these we call it silver iodobromide, because this silver has got iodine also, bromine also, but AgBr is present in maximum number, somewhere around 95% to 98% of there is there, and the silver iodide we have is in very less amount, that is 2%, and sometimes we put some sulfur contamination also, so because we want to increase the photosensitivity. So this silver iodide, which we are putting in very less quantity, also that adds up the sensitivity of the film. That means we do not require much dose of radiation for the image to develop. That means in the small wavelength also, we can develop the image. We can produce the image. That is the reason. And you know what emulsion is known as? The heart of the film. And this is the reason that I am using red color for this, so that you can remember it easily. So emulsion is the heart of the film. It consists of silver halide crystals. Now these silver halide crystals are, suppose this is the emulsion. So there is going to be a background of the gelatin. In that there are silver halide crystals. So like that. So these silver halide crystals, they will contain majority silver bromide and less contains silver iodide, right? So X-ray has got two principles. Till now we have covered that there is a base which is present in the middle, which is made up of polyester, which is the polyethylene tetraphthalate. Then we have got the emulsion which is made up of silver halide crystals, which is inside, which is floating, you can say. You know, crystals are swimming in this swimming pool of gelatin. Have you seen in the Facebook that some people are making their pool of gelatin and then they are jumping it, and then there is a bouncing back? You have seen all these things, right? So imagine that pool of gelatin. Imagine that pool of gelatin, and these guys, little fellows, are the silver halide crystals. People who are jumping, who are playing in the gelatin pool. Now, the gelatin is helpful during the processing. That gelatin is going to absorb the processing solution. And that is the reason, because we want the processing solution to react with the silver halide crystals, to react with the silver halide grains. And that is the reason that image is going to develop. Because we want a reaction with the silver halide, right? That is the reason that we are putting silver halide, which is the radio sensitive. So, for that reason, we are putting gelatin, so that the gelatin absorb the processing. During processing, it absorb the processing solution. So, we have got two kind of films. One is the single coated film. Suppose if there is no emulsion on the other side. So, there is no emulsion on the other side. That means the film is like this. Then the film is our single coated film. Now, this kind of film we use in CT scan, CT films, we use in mammographic films, because there we want a sharp image, high quality image. But most of our films which we use, and in dentistry also which we use, are our double coated film, in which both the sides emulsion is there. See, as the name suggests, double coated, that means both the side there is going to be the coating of the emulsion, and above that there is going to be a super coat, and in between both are joined with the adhesive, right? So the super coat, you know what the purpose of the super coat is? That let me write it, super coat. So you can say super coat or background or overcoat. So this super coat is also made up of gelatin, but it is going to protect the film, and it is going to protect it from scratching, from contamination, or while the processing, if you are putting any pressure. So all of these mechanical damage super coat is protecting from, right? And the emulsion is again made up of silver halide. So if you look at the thickness, emulsion is thinner than the base. So the thickness of emulsion, see, it depends on book to book. So some books it is written 3 to 5 micrometer. So you can remember the range is from 3 to 10. Somewhere it will be in between this range only. Right, but it consists of silver halide crystals in the gelatin. This gelatin is made from the bone of the kettle. So the emulsion, we call it the heart of the film. Because it is going to absorb the radiations, it is radio sensitive, and it is going to produce the image. So based on that also, we have got two kinds of film. One is the direct exposure film. The direct exposure film is one, the IOPR. That means we are exposing the IOPR directly to the X-ray radiation. Right, this is the, we directly exposed to the X-ray radiation. The another one is the screen film. Now screen film is like, have you seen these radio cassettes, all very old time, the radio cassettes? So what is there? There is a cover of the cassette. So the film is put in a box that we will cover in the intensifying screen. But remember this, that the screen film are basically extra oral, and which we are combining with the intensifying screens. So in between is our base layer, which is made up of polyethylene tetraethylate, which is a polyester, right? So this base is little bit thicker compared to the emulsion, and the thickness of this base is somewhere around 150 to 300 micrometer. But the newer film are very thinner, so which are 175 micrometer. So compared to the emulsion, base is thicker, but the base should have the flexibility, right? And have you seen this, a little bluish tint there is present on the base? Now, why there is a tint which is present? Because there is a, because of that blue tint, there is a less strain to the eyes of the radiologist. So that when a radiologist is whole day looking at the radiographs and diagnosing things, his eye is not getting fatigued, his eye is not getting tired, so that he can diagnose it accurately. And there is one more thing which we call it the crossover effect. The crossover effect is, let me show you this crossover effect. What happens when there is a light coming? So the rays will go like that, right? So what happens? They see at the emulsion they are going to stop, otherwise what would happen? Because see, the film base is actually coated with phosphor layer. So there is a special layer we call phosphor layer, both the sides, here also, here also. So this phosphor layer will stop these X-ray radiation, will prevent the light crossing over to the other part of the screen. So if this light cross over to the other part of screen, then there will be, because of the reflection of the light, there is going to be the blurring of the image. So that is also stopping, this blue tinge is also stopping this reflection of the light, stopping the blurring of the image. We call it the crossover effect. So there are two things why there is a blue tinge. First of all, because to reduce the fatigue to the eyes of the radiologist, and the crossover effect. So guys, this is about the X-ray film. I hope that you have enjoyed the video. The crossover effect, you will find it on the internet if you want that, because we want the base to stop the light, right? Otherwise the image picture which is coming, because it is scattering, so when it is passed, it is going to be magnified, so there is going to be the blurring of the image, but we want that the image comes very precise. So this is about the X-ray film, and I hope that you know that the dot in the IOPR film, so there is a dot in the IOPR film. If you see this IOPR film, there is going to be elevated surface one side, and there is going to be the other side a depressed surface. So like dot, but it will be depressed, right? So the elevated part of the dot of the film, we usually place it towards the side of the tube. Why we are doing so? What is the significance of the dot? There may ask in the Viva that what is the significance of the dot? This dot is used for the film orientation. So when we know that this dot is present on the towards the tube side, so whenever we are taking X-ray, we have to always remember that the raised part of the dot, we are placing it. Suppose this is the X-ray tube, from this X-ray is emitting. So the dot part, suppose this is a dot, this is a dot, and this is a raised dot. So once I am taking X-ray, suppose X-rays are coming from this, this is the tube head. So when the X-rays are coming, this elevated dot will be towards the tube head, X-ray tube head, X-ray tube. So this is how we know that which quadrant it is. Either it is a right side or a left side, and the depressed dot, we keep it towards the tissue side, toward the tongue or anything. Right, IUPR size also, let's cover in this video itself. So we have got IUPR size. So 0 size, 1 size and 2 size of IOPR. So 0 is the smallest size. We use in small children. Like 0 size, if you want to see the measurement, 22 into 35, white and ferro it is from. So 1 is our 24 into 40 millimeter. And 2 is our 32 into 41 millimeter. So 0 size film, we use it in small children. 1 size film, we use it for anterior teeth. And 2 size film is our standard film, is the standard IOPR film. Basically, we use this film for all the X-ray purposes in the adult teeth. Right. Then like that, we also have in the bite wing also. So bite wing radiograph, we used to detect the proximal caries. Right. So this is like the bite wing radiograph. So bite wing radiograph, basically, what we are going to do in bite wing radiograph? Bite wing radiograph, 0 size is our very small children. 1 size is for, again, children, and 2 sizes for our adults. So two sizes always for adult, right? So guys, this is about the X-ray film. In between, there is a base which is made up of poly, which is made up of polyester, and we have got either sides in the double coated film. We have got emulsion, which is made up of silver halide in the gelatin matrix, and the upper layer we have got a super coat to protect it from the mechanical damage. So if you have enjoyed the video, then give it a thumbs up. Also, you can comment in the comment section below. There is a link in the description box below to support me on Paytm as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. So till then, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated. I'll see you soon in the next video.